Right, good evening everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And as you can probably gather, because there's a splash screen, this is sort of like the first of what I would say is kind of like a new series of video live stream slash probably recorded videos of me basically just driving around certain routes I haven't really driven before. Now, I picked up this route, which is the North Wales Coastal, the full version from Holyhead to Crewe. So we're going to be running that today. I think this version I've got also has down to Blenalfest Diniog, which I'll probably cover another time, but we're going to go to Crewe today from Holyhead. So I'm probably going to be basically showcasing the route, but I'm also going to be showcasing the AP HFT packs that I have, you know, recently got. So where are we? We're at Holyhead. We're at what I believe is the old... what used to be anyway, the terminal, I think, or still is the ferry terminal. Because Holyhead for the LMS was a very important place, because obviously you had the steamers that went over to Ireland. So Holyhead was kind of like interesting as well, because this is a Welsh area with LMS sort of background, which is kind of interesting. This isn't actually the fully end of the line though from Holyhead, because technically speaking you've also got the sidings up here. I don't know if anybody lives in Holyhead who watches these streams. I doubt that. But I don't know whether people think these details are correct from what they've seen. I mean, I've never been here. I've never wanted to come here. But from what I can see, at least they put in some, you know, more modern detail and whatnot. As in, you know, they've actually done their research. I'm kind of being a bit cheeky anyway with my choice of motive power, because I know these don't run on this line. But because Virgin Trains holds part of the franchise... I'm running a Virgin Train HFT because, you know, why not? And in the other platform, I think, is one of these weird things. Can't remember what it's called. It's like a Cordella or something like that. Anyway, I've got a bit of a dicky tummy because I've had a bit too much to drink. Don't worry, not alcohol. So anyway, we're going to be going from Holyhead to Crewe. So I'm on my Tollingtons because everyone abandoned me, as usual. So we are going to attempt to get going. I just need to work out if I can get the brakes and things off first. Because last time I tried this... Oh yeah, there we go. Got the brakes off. So... And we've got power. So let's go. Now for those diesel veg out there who like diesels, duh... I'm going to turn the sounds up a little bit for this stream because this thing does sound pretty good. And we'll probably get a window hang most of the way. Because if I'm correct in thinking, yes, the camera view is right behind the cab of the HFT. So anyway, we're going to leave Holyhead. We're going to head to Crewe, which is 105.5 miles away. Now, I got this route as well while it was on discount. So I didn't get the full discount because I'm stupid, didn't realise there was a double pack. But I did get it for like under a tenner, so that's not bad. So without further ado, I mean, I'm just basically going to drive probably both from the cab and the sides and whatever, and I'm just going to sort of describe what I like and don't like about the route. Again, seeing as there's none of my regulars around on Discord, I'll be on my own for the duration of this stream by the looks of it. I love how YouTube reckons it's not receiving enough content. That's interesting, because it clearly should be. Although it claims it's dropping many, many frames, which is, again, unreal. So, I don't know. It's a bit interesting. So, that's another thing that's a shame as well with the HFTs as well, is that, as someone just pointed out in the comments, they are indeed going out of fashion, as in they're going out, as in they're not going to be running on the main line much anymore. Which is a shame, I think, because, as I said to the guys last night, I was running this route the opposite way yesterday. I said that the thing with the HFTs is, yeah, they're not my favourite diesel locomotive in the world, but they are an icon of Britain. They're an icon of high-speed rail. These are the fastest diesel units we had, and now they're going. So, I know they're mainly gone on most of the networks, and I think a couple are being kept, but still... It would be, it's a shame, really. Because as I say, you know, HFTs are those, like, you know, if you ever think of a British high-speed train, your first thought is going to be of a HFT. So let's give it some thrash. Now, I will point out I'm going to try and drive this slightly properly, so I'm going to attempt to follow the speed limits and such, if I can. And I'm going to try and stop at certain places. So I think the first place I'm going to stop is Llandudno Junction. And then I think Chester after that. But as I say, I'm going to try and observe the speed limit because I kind of want to show off quite a bit. I want to actually show off the route a little bit because I think it's actually like a nice little route, to be fair. Right, we're speeding now, so let's notch off. A little bit of brake. So this enhancement pack actually does breathe new life into the old HFT. Wonder whether they'll ever make a new HFT. I mean, I doubt that, but at least we've got plenty of sound for it. I don't know quite why we've got a 15 limit there, but... Oh, I think there's a container terminal or something somewhere along here, or at least a dock. I'll have to look at the map later on. But we're about to go through Valley Station. So, again, I'm not going to pretend I know what these look like in real life. I'm just going to basically comment on how nice it looks. And, well, with all the settings and whatnot I've got on, and Railworks Enhancer and whatnot, of course it looks very nice. Dare I say it, these sort of routes look a lot better than the Train Sim World route I was running yesterday and the day before. So through Valley Station we go. Very small station. Because it's in the valleys. Well, actually it isn't in the valleys, it's sort of in the, you know, open, I suppose. So, there we go. I suppose we better notch up one or two. Notch two will do. Oh, a window hang! Oh, yeah. Unfortunately, this isn't going to be me being very chatty on the stream. This is just literally me doing essentially what you could call like a semi-cab ride. Just basically a look around of this route. Because again, like, I mean, I'm planning on doing another video on the South Wales Coastal at some point. I might even make that my part two to this video. Because I'm kind of doing the Welshness. I might even do the Ferdinand Welsh Highland again. The only problem is I kind of need to get the extra bits and bobs for it. Because what I'd really, really like to be able to do is run all the way up with the Garrets. But I need to work out how to modify the Garrets that are in-game. Because for some reason I can't get any water on them. As in they're just bone dry. So I don't know whether there's any sort of patch for them. I also might have to take some suggestions from you guys on what I should drive on South Wales Coastal. Because I just sort of picked a HFT for this one from Holyhead to Crewe. So I'm kind of thinking maybe I might do, I think we'll go Swansea to Bristol. So we're going from Wales into England, so I'm basically running home each time. So, I'll let you guys maybe choose what we use on the South Wales Coastal run. Because, again, I'm only using a Virgin HFT because it's kind of like what I'm doing is running a fictional sort of what-if case, which is like, you know, what if Virgin trains ran a heritage... high-speed train unit along here one day. So we're about to come through a station I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce, because last time I tried to pronounce this I got in trouble. It's like Rosnig, I'm not even going to say it because I'm going to say the n-word otherwise. It's Rosnigra, we'll call it that. Rosnigra. Okay, I can't get in trouble then, Anthony, if you're watching. Anyway, let's watch this HFT come through the flatlands. See, there's no point stopping here because it's such a small station. Look good though. Nice bit of a lenta screen there. If only for a second or two. Right, time to go through. I need someone Welsh really in the call to pronounce his name for me. Tycross? I don't know. I don't know how you pronounce it. It's like Tekka. I like how somebody in the comments has suggested a steamroller to use in another version of this. It's like, oh, okay. Oh, I see that I have been called upon. Oh well, if Crane's around, I better get Crane in the call. Crane!
Hello.
Hello, you can help me with the stream tonight then, seeing as everyone else has abandoned me.
Oh, okay.
So you're now my so we've got Crane, ladies and gentlemen. Crane is our co-driver today. Crane, how are you feeling?
I'm terrified.
Excellent, that's what I like to hear. Anyway. So
are you taking me hostage? Please help me. Okay.
I haven't taken him hostage before anyone asks. Anyway,
suddenly someone asks.
Yeah, someone did ask. What I was going to say to you anyway, Crane, was, so have you actually ever seen this route before? Like, has anyone ever mentioned
no.
it to you? Okay. Were you here last night when I was driving the other direction?
No.
Right, good. Then you've got your fresh pair of eyes from the stream then. Oh, God, lag. So, yeah, basically I was just explaining as well that this route is 100 miles long. That's pretty good, to be fair.
Oh, well, yeah. Usually most routes are about 80 or so miles, aren't they? Or
yeah, just, normally they're quite...
the amount of space you can work with.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the map for this route, it's... because we are only... we've left Holyhead, which is up here, and we're now down here, heading towards Llandudno Junction, which is here. But then this bit here is actually an add-on from Backdated Train Sim to Blenheim Ffestiniog, which is down here.
Good.
So you've got the Ffestiniog Railway a little bit there. And then it goes all the way down to Chester, and then into Crewe, where the Heritage Centre is. So, where we're going to probably go. So, where are we now? We need to slow down a little bit. But I thought I'd just... this sort of series of videos, Crane, I thought I'd just sort of be a bit more serious, a bit more... not PC as such, but I was reading something today that made me a little bit pensive, you know? About... hang on, let's just tone through here.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, like, YouTube is basically going to be more tailoring itself towards children now, which is, like, a bit annoying because... let me put it this way, you're not going to get half as good a content because the girl I've been looking after recently, she watches this thing called Spy Ninjas. And it's...
I think I've heard of that before.
It's the most... oh my God. I mean, how would you describe it, Trace? It's like the dumb... well, I'm not going to swear, but the dumbest crap I've ever seen. It's like... it basically seems like it's tailored towards babies.
Yeah.
I'm going to just open up in a tunnel quick. Hold on. And then back off the power.
No.
Well, it's only through the tunnel. But anyway, the problem is these things are so mind-numbing and they're so tailored towards children. There's going to be no content for sort of young adults to watch on YouTube soon. You know, so what? We swear a little bit. That's fine. Like, a little bit of swearing never hurt anyone. But for example, my channel, I'm worried about it because I was thinking to myself, well, does that mean I'm going to get in trouble on my channel, do you think? Because, I mean, like, it's not like I post anything sort of like, you know, about, like, I don't do hate speech or anything. I don't do anything like that. I mean, do you reckon I'll be alright with TGIS or what?
I reckon you'll be alright.
I hope
but
so.
Aren't you sponsored? Aren't you? Yeah, you're sponsored by sponsors.
I'm sponsored by myself.
Yeah.
I'm a YouTube
Patreon mod.
Well, I am, but money situation on Patreon is a bit pants because not enough people are paying into it. But that isn't the most important thing. It's more the fact I'm worried that I wouldn't be able to I'd have to maybe think about either moving to a different platform if that came to the fact. But I'm much happier just using YouTube as it is. So,
yeah.
I mean, I don't want to lose that, you know?
Yeah. I can't really say anything wrong. I mean, you don't go, like, you don't do any hate speech at all. You're not discriminative. You're not racist.
You say that. We are pretty racist on this channel. We do plenty of races.
Well,
and we have said the, in our own private conversations, we do sometimes say, you know, things. But I try and keep them sort of, I don't know, like, within the context.
About the LNER.
Well, that's because no one likes the LNER. Suddenly James Wright exploded.
Again.
Ooh, Crane, we're on a 1 in 97. You know what that means, don't you?
Thrash.
Yep, time to get out of the cab and thrash.
Woohoo!
Get a good notch free, see how we go. What are you thinking of the route anyway? I think it's quite well detailed.
Especially with the lighting and whatnot, it really helped bring it out.
Yeah.
Even though it's just Wales and it's never usually sunny, but even still.
Yeah, well, we're just pretending. We've got one of those rare days.
I know. Those rare days in winter when it's sunny, but you're still fucking freezing.
Yeah, so it's a nice sunny day, but it's still bloody cold.
Yeah.
Power!
Oops, okay.
Just while we're on a bank. Power!
It's probably because I've seen the Hornby one too many times, but I keep thinking of the Hornby HSTs every time I see that livery.
I know, because it's basically the Hornby livery, isn't it?
Yeah, they've made another model train in Train Sim.
Oh,
Joe, now this.
Oh, well, it's fine.
It's nice.
Like it anyway, I like it. I kind of like it, it's a bit more interesting to have a red train, isn't it?
The big red train thundering down the line.
It's a magic
I do like
train.
Those coaches, I will admit.
I'll tell you which one I'm most interested in. Hold on. The buffet one here. Because for
That's
some reason...
Funny.
Yeah, because on like one side it's like that.
And suddenly...
And then on the other side it's open like that.
Mm.
So, I don't know what that's all about.
Is there any interior decorations? Like interior design where it is?
Not really, no. No, because I can't get in there anyway. Because the only camera you've got is this one.
Which is fine.
The hostage
carriage, then?
Yeah, wait, the what carriage?
The hostage carriage.
I thought you said the Hoskins carriage. I was going to say, what did Jeremy Hoskins do? What would Jeremy Hoskins do in this situation? Oh, I also want to kind of point out, I know it's sort of like, you know, not the content of the stream, but I have written episode 3 of TDRS season 9, and that will be coming out once the voice actors get back to me with their voice acting stuff. So basically nobody got back to me yet. So I'm looking to have episode 3 done sort of maybe the beginning of December. But I think they might attempt a possible Christmas special perhaps. But I don't know yet.
Don't stress yourself doing it.
I ain't stressing myself. I've got more important things at the moment. So for example, I've probably got a lot of overtime coming up at work, and also looking after Paige a lot more. Like, I'm babysitting her Thursday night, and then Friday night, I'm looking after her again with Trace. So, she's a sweet kid, so I'm going to look after her a bit more. She sees me more like a... She said to me today, like, she looked up to me as like a dad. It's like, no, I'm not your dad. I'm your funcle.
Your what, sorry?
I'm a her funcle. A fun uncle.
Okay, right.
What do you think I meant?
Nothing. All I heard was a fun call. It's just like, more fun, and I didn't get the uncle part.
Yeah, fun call. Fun call. Fun call.
Fun
uncle.
Fun cool.
It's fun call.
Cool.
Yeah, fun call.
Like what's a fun call?
F-U-N-C-L-E. Fun call.
Oh, right. It was fun, and then C-O-O-L. Fun cool.
No, fun call. Fun call. My God. I'm her fun uncle.
Okay, dude. Now I understand.
Yeah. Now you get it. But anyway, she's becoming quite important, so yeah, I've got to be aware of that.
Be aware. Be something.
Be what?
Be aware and be
square.
I don't know.
Be aware and be square. Anyway, I don't know where everyone is today. Like, I'd have thought there'd be loads of people around, but there's clearly not.
I don't know. I think everyone's too busy drinking cider and whatnot.
Good idea, Crane.
Yeah, well, I've got one in the fridge. I need to actually have it. I will have a sip of it sooner or later.
I might go grab my, what do you call it? I've got some Copperberg cans in the fridge, so I might go grab one.
Lovely.
Yeah, me and Trace, unfortunately, we went shopping today. And we had it to deliver at 2 o'clock, but they sent it to my old address. The one I used to live in Bournemouth. So
yeah.
It went back, and we had to. We phoned them up like, well, "Where's our delivery?" And they're like, "Oh, we sent it to this X address." I'm not going to say what it is. And I said, "No, that's not our address. It's our other address. We now live here."
Oh, hi, Riley.
Oh, we have another. Oh, we have a Riley.
He's in the YouTube chassis.
Oh,
there we are.
He's in the YouTubes. Right, we've got to slow down to 40 miles an hour, apparently.
How dare you? We're supposed to be going 126 miles an hour.
No, not. Oh my God! Look how small this station is. Oh,
holy!
That is cute.
It's
like a little two-car station. It's like, oh, it's so cute.
You.
It's a cute little station. It's a funky little station, isn't it, Crane?
I should stop swearing.
I'm not swearing.
No, me.
Oh yeah, you should. Wait, I didn't even realise you were swearing. Stop swearing.
Okay. Well, we're back in the hostage car with me.
Back to the hostage situation with you, Crane. Now, I'm not sure why it goes to 40 miles an hour, but I think it might be a single track section here, if I remember correctly.
Possibly.
I think, in fact, it's a single track section because there's an awesome bridge coming up where you go underneath a road on the bridge. Yeah, I think it is. So while we're going quiet, we'll go over this view. So yeah, I mean, I actually think this is a nice little route to drive on. Well, I say little, nice big route to drive on.
I must say little. It's 100 fucking miles.
Well, if you want something a bit different, I mean, this has got it all. Like, you know, for example, I'm on a single track under a bridge. Next.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go, Crane. Look, you see what we're doing here?
Whee!
Well, yeah. You'll see what we're doing. We're going underneath a bridge.
Okay.
So what I want to try and do is get off.
Looks fairly modern.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. That is awesome. It's awesome, isn't it?
That's the bridge. Oh.
I'm going to pause it. Well, I'm not going to pause it. I'm going to try and get a screenshot while going over it. Hang on. In fact, I will pause it just so I can get a good angle. That is a nice little bridge. Hang on. Wait, what's this?
Yeah.
Ooh, what's this?
That is actually a good little view. Hello, Wall.
Hello, Wall. How are you today? Well, actually, that gives us some purchase so that in reality you'd see... Where?
Yeah.
Oh, that's actually.
This is the heritage view from the cameras and all that jazz.
Yeah.
From the camera and the reflection as well. Look at that.
Yeah, I know. It's beautiful, isn't it? Anyway, screenshot ready. Boom. And then, so we come under the bridge. And there's I don't know whether that's meant to be a walkway or whether that's where it used to be double track or something, but then it sort of curves under this way. I love that.
Yeah. I don't know if it is or not, but it kind of reminds me of those like American sort of bridge with those subway cars under those big bridges and whatnot, like New York.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, I know exactly what bridge you're talking about. The one where you got the subway train coming underneath, yeah.
Yeah.
What stopped? Oh, I paused it so I can take a picture.
Oh, right. I was like, oh, did you stall that quickly?
No, just took a picture. The problem is, it sounds like a car alarm if I do it properly. Right, we're now on to a 45 section, so let's speed up again.
Okay.
So where exactly on the route is this bit? Hang on, let's centre player. So it's this bit here we've just gone over, this bridge.
Really?
That is actually probably one of my favourite parts so far.
Yeah.
Just because of how unique it is, as in unique in train sim, because we don't see that very often, do we?
Yeah, very true. Does it say what the bridge is called?
No. Someone in the comments will tell us, I think.
Okay. Please, Can someone please email me the security number and what the name of the bridge is, please?
Yeah, you also need to give us the 3-digit code on the back of your card. Because why not? So it does make a difference with this enhancement pack on the HMT, to be fair.
It does, indeed.
I mean, like, it's not a groundbreaking thing, it's not like a brand new model, but at least you've got lots of different liveries for different time periods. Like, you know, even though I'm running this Virgin Trains one and unbranded, I could say that this is a, you know, because it's obviously set in modern day, I could say it's a heritage heritage set that Virgin Trains may have kept. Who knows?
The thing is, as well, I do like the Virgin livery. I can't say that right without, well, chuckling a bit, saying the Virgin livery.
Put Virgin.
Oi!
Quit it.
Oi. Sorry. Because I do like Virgin Trains livery. It's just that, well, the modern ones with the pendolinos is just me.
That's what it is. Oh, excuse me. Bit burpy at the moment. Oh, look, there's a Cordalia. Or whatever it's called. Is it a Cordalia?
It's got a very... I think it's got missing textures.
It's a transport for whales, though. Yeah, did it have missing textures?
Smoke.
Did it?
Yeah.
That's pretty odd.
Hello, tunnel.
Time to 420 blaze it again.
Oh, God.
I can't help it. You've got a tunnel. You've got to thrash it.
Oh,
yeah.
Not late yet.
Oh, yeah. Did you ever come up with
what's to go in the museum, by the way?
Hang on,
Crane.
Look out the tunnel first, then I'll tell you.
Okay.
Right, we've only got a little section if we go through Bangor up Main. Bangor. Yeah, we're going through Bangor here. So, hang on, quick question then for the peeps watching. Does this look at all like Bangor Station? And are we going to Bangor?
No.
Plunkin' Bangor. That would be wonderful, said Trevor. But yeah, I did. At the moment, I've got Buckleby Grange and Goldbourne. We need to still go through and have a look.
Buckleby Grange.
Yeah, we got in there, but we got you literally right next to him, Crane. Like, I put you in the museum. Did you see the picture?
Oh, no.
Oh, I ain't got a picture on me to hand, but basically it's a picture of, like, Buckleby Grange next to the Crane. Because Crane's going to make sure he doesn't fall over. Seeing as that's Bucks.
Oh, I'm your carer. Oh, I don't need a carer. Bang. Oh.
Yeah, just falls over and he is asleep. Right, okay, we've got to ease off again now.
You're speedy. Oh no, call the police.
Yay, police. Wait, no. Don't do that. Don't call the police. The police scare me. Where?
Call the Raymond police. Oh gosh.
Headlights aren't very good, is it?
Well, no. I think it's just mainly for people to see you rather than you see where you're going. I think you're supposed to know where you're supposed to be going, Tom.
No? Where am I?
I don't know.
I don't even know where I am either.
I thought you would know.
Oh, look, a bridge. Wow, look, a bridge. Digital styles.
Hey, deja vu.
Deja vu, I think I've seen this bridge before.
Well, it's a bridge, so. It's not a very tall bridge, but it's a bridge.
Is it a bridge? There is something about a HFT that is very, what's the word? It's, there's a word for it. It's like, it's very, mesmerizing and sort of like, you know, is it svelte? Is it svelte, I'm thinking? It's like elegant, isn't it?
It's quite elegant in a way. I know a lot of people criticise them because they're not the steam engine, they've not got the things moving around the side, but...
Oh, well.
They've still got
They've got character, though. A HMT has got character. So, I don't know where we are now, but we need to pick up some more speed again.
I can tell you where we are.
We are in the middle of nowhere. Oh, I know where we are. Yes! Well done! I like the fact we're going all along the north coast of Wales, but... There's actually not that much coast. Like, at the moment, I'm nowhere near the coast. Where is it?
Where's the coast? They didn't misspell it with, instead of a C, it was supposed to be a T.
What, Toastal?
Yeah, it was a buffet car back there, so...
North Wales Toastal. And South Wales Toastal as well. Toasting chickens or something, aren't they?
Chickens?
Anyway, good that I finally got a co-pilot.
Am I supposed to be doing something?
Yeah, you're my co-pilot. You're someone for me to talk to while I do these streams. Problem is that if I do them on my own, I don't feel like sometimes I can carry them.
Yeah. Well, like, I always have someone good to bounce off of. So.
Oh, yeah. I mean, like, I can do them on my own if they're like a dark tries or something, but when I'm doing a long run like this, sometimes it's nice to have somebody. Not that I don't mind doing it on my own. I would have happily done it on my own if I hadn't seen you around, but let's put it this way, I don't want all the cheese heads in that we usually get, like, you know, all the shouty cheese heads.
Oh.
It's nice to just have one person in the cab, so.
Yeah. Well, you've always got Tracy as well. I don't know, is she still there or?
Yeah, she's doing her training, I think, so she's unavailable to talk to.
Okay.
She's got to do that training.
Training. Not training.
She's doing training standards.
Uh-huh.
Suddenly, training standards knocked at the door.
Oh no! It's the standard police.
Coat hangers, open up!
Oh my god! Anyway, this section of the route is a little bit yawn. I mean, it's not like the. Well, it's just a bit too. You know, there's not really much going on, is there?
It's straight.
I did say that I noticed. I think just before we get to Landed No Junction. That some of the cliff work that we're about to go through, when I came through yesterday, was a little bit on the iffy side. I'll show you what I mean when we get to them. They're a bit jagged. But, you know, overall, I think it's a good little route. I say, well, a little. You know what I mean? It's a good route. It's good if you do fancy a long drive like I'm doing this for. Because I just fancy driving a HMT for some reason. So.
Is that a 90? Are you now allowed up to 90?
Yes, it is a 90. Let's do it.
Okay. Is a cab any good, by the way? Does it look any good?
The cab?
Yeah.
Yeah, the cab looks alright. Oh, hang on, we're coming up to land. Oh, we're coming up to land for whatever that is.
Landfly. Oh, I can't do that for a really long day.
Is that actually. Oh, that ain't a long place, is it?
I don't. I hope not.
I hope not too.
To pronounce it, I ain't doing it.
You can be our guard.
Guard?
Guard?
I cannot pronounce what the hell that says.
It's like land perfection, something like that. Land perfection or something like that.
Yeah. A couple of Brits coming to Wales and don't know how the hell things work. What the hell is that?
Why did they hire an English driver like me to come to Wales for this run?
Why were they drunk when they would think they were trying to pronounce these names?
That sounded hilarious.
So is it just normal, like, standard, standard class? Yeah, third class carriages and one buffet car, or...?
I'm not sure. Anyway, through we go.
Oh, what's this thing?
That's that Lanfair Fetchum place.
Oh.
It's a car.
Oh no, not a car.
Lanfair station, though.
Yeah.
Lanfair.
Why are the cars all shiny, by the way?
Don't know, they just are. Lanfair Fetchin, we're going to call it. Oh look, coastline! Look! We're finally on the North Wales coast, Greg, we made it!
Yay, toast!
Oh. There's a van just randomly parked there.
Why is there crossing gates? I'm surely they would be like level barrier things. Hello, van.
Oh god, we've got to slow down.
What's a slowdown?
It means we've got to reduce speed immediately.
Tom, someone's broken into the cab!
Uh-oh, who's broken into the cab?
It's Anthony!
Oh no. What are you doing here? Why are you in my cab?
Post!
Post?
This ain't the post train, mate. You're on the wrong train. I know it's the same colour as the post train, but still.
I'm about to say, this isn't the great train robbery.
By the way, Crane, look at that cliff base there. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Like, look how jagged and horrible that looks.
Yeah. I mean, the textures are okay, but the grass is just like, what the fudge?
Oh, God, look at that glitch. Anyway, that was all I wanted to show. That's the one bit I was a little bit disappointed with when I did this yesterday.
Well, it's quite a scenic little thing. Like, you would think it would be...
You'd think that one part, they would just... I mean, I know that this bit is an extension from their land... Like, because originally the route was just landed no to crew. So... They extended it to Holyhead, but still, that would have been, it would have been nice if they'd have done that bit properly, wouldn't it? But, oh no, that's one small gripe. One more gripe so far. At least there's plenty of nice assets like that. That looks nice.
Yeah.
And then,
so, Mr. Postman, what is Postman was sounding excited about something, by the way.
What?
What is post? Well, I think you just ran over someone, by the way, Tom.
Excellent. It was an accident, but...
Or was it?
Anyway, how is Anthony then? And how did he get on my train?
Post.
Post?
But did Tablet's we... What did we do? Did we just literally, like... Did we extend one of those, tablet catchers or something and you just randomly caught onto it and then got sucked into the train? Or did you do what happened to me the other day when I was trying to TF World, when I managed to get inside a HFT carriage by standing in the middle of the track and letting HFT run over me? Yeah, I don't...
It's more a case of, you know, to quote a certain video, the Reverend's gone. I must catch the Reverend.
Anyway, as you can tell, Anton, I'm trying to do a slightly serious drive today. I think it's also something...
Wales.
Yeah, I know we're in Wales. It's also something that Paige said to me about this whole YouTube safety... Not safety thing, like, you know, being more catered towards children thing. That could kill a lot of channels, I think.
Well, if they're ready to make money, then yeah. But...
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm not aiming to make money off it. Like, I'm just more... For me, it's more like, you know, I like entertaining you lot. That's
banter.
Literally... Well, yeah, for the bands.
To take those pants off those bands. I mean, what? Yeah, I take it, by the way, Anthony, because you're saying post. I take it you got something in the post? Have you got an Ivor or something?
No.
Oh. Did you win that eBay bidding of the Ivor too?
I didn't bid on it. I can't. I need money.
Oh.
What? Fuck you, Chris! Fuck you!
Excuse me, we're trying to be PC in this stream.
Well, tough. We're not PC.
We are now.
We're trying to be Pete and Claude.
Anyway, let's replace Anthony's harsh language with some trash.
We're not PC Selby.
We are. No, we're PC Pullman.
Come on, lads. There's no clothes. You must have read the signs.
Da, da, do, 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 do.
We'll have to take your dresses. Don't be daft, Arthur. You know we wear trousers. Why not? Had it. How do you shop the pizza?
I think we might have to stop at Conway, you know.
What's a little Anthony?
Yeah, get him out of there.
Be off.
Be off. Be off.
So, Anthony, how'd you like being taken hostage?
I'm not hostage.
I still don't know how he got in our cab.
I know. Here I was, just having a nice cup of tea, then suddenly I'm a hostage.
Oh, we're coming up to Landed now anyway. So we don't need to stop. We don't really need to stop at Conway then. If we're going straight to Land, our main stop is Llandudno Junction, so.
Can we get some biscuits while we're there?
No. Why biscuits?
I need some for my tea.
No, go to the buffet car.
But they don't have any biscuits.
Well, ask them nicely.
Please?
Is it missing? Are they missing tension crane? No, they're not.
They look very squared.
They do. They don't look right.
I thought they were missing textures. Thingies.
No, apparently not.
Because you've got to remember, I don't play a lot of train sims, so...
No, it did look very similar to, you know. But anyway, to answer your question, Crane, yeah. Cab does look alright, actually. And it's got cab light.
Oh. It does have that 80s feel, especially with how chunky the plastic is around the cab.
Oh, this one's a station I like, because you go straight through a castle wall here. That's awesome. Look. See that? Hang on. If I can... Ah!
That is swish.
If I can get the 8 camera on. See, that is cool.
Don't tell Mr. Dexby. He'll have that for his railway.
I kind of want it for my railway. The dark railway was suddenly overtaken by a castle. I mean, is that actually a castle, or is it just like a wall? It's just a... Oh, it is actually part of the castle.
Yeah.
Oh, hello. Why'd that train just stop there?
Oh, I know that bridge. Where do I know it from?
Because it's Conwy Bridge.
Yeah. It's actually quite a nice bridge, that one, especially with, well, how it was engineered and whatnot.
So my question is, now we've gone past, does the Cordalia go? Wait, hang on, it's a Sprinter!
Oh.
In a Revertrain Wales livery, that's cool, I like that.
Oh, that's outdated now, boy, oh, you need to change that to Transport for Wales, you know.
Oh, shut up!
I mean, to be fair, I'm pretty sure most of the trains, like, on the Welsh network still
carry Reaver. Right, okay, so here we are at Llandilo Junction.
I will say that I'm not the biggest fan of the new Transport for Wales livery. It just looks
bland.
I mean, I like the white and red, but it's just a bit, yeah, bland. It also looks way too similar to Greater Anglia to me.
That's a nice looking station, I will admit.
Well, I want to explore while we're stopped here, because obviously I downloaded that thing from Backdate Trainson that includes the Conwy Valley down to Blandow Ffestiniog. So I think at some point I will explore from... I'll explore the Llandudno branch next, I think. From Llandudno up to... what do you call it?
A place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's taken us 43 minutes driving at more or less the speed limit to get here from... So where are we now? We are... We've sent the player. So we are here at Llandudno Junction. It's taken us 45 minutes to go that far. Wonder how long it would take us to go the rest of the journey. I think we've only done 40 miles.
Yeah. Well, if you put your foot down and ignore the speed limits, you might get there.
Yeah, but why would I do that?
I don't know.
So anyway, so this is Llandudno Junction. So where... So that's the line up to Llandudno there.
Yeah.
I assume. Up the coast.
The toast coast.
And then, so the line to Blenau Ffestiniog must... Ah! I think it is...
Somewhere.
Oh, it's down here.
Okay.
So the Conwy Valley line goes that way. So yeah, we'll do that another time in another Dark Drives, seeing as this is now a new series. Anyway, shall we get going? Shall we thrash it at the station, Crane?
I don't know. Have the police arrived yet?
Shall we thrash it from the station, Thomas, to see some more jolly folk from the town?
Shall we poison all the people on the platform with our smoke?
Anyway. Right.
Oh, thank you, Ethan, for my chocolate digestives.
Thrash! Why did Ethan turn up?
Ethan47XX, whoever.
Oh, okay.
Remember, we're in the Patreon chat thing. The only Patreons can get here.
And admins, thank God.
Oh yeah, and that too. Is it supposed to have, like, the Virgin's livery on the side?
I think it's supposed to, but I never got the branding patch for this, so... Because I think there's a branding patch on UKTS, and Screw sitting in, you know, giant queues for that. Or buying a thingy bob. So that's Llandudno Junction. So yeah, so far I'm quite liking the route.
I cannot unsee that as only just... I keep seeing it as the Hornby bloody train set, train pack thing with the HSTs.
Can you bring me a Copperberg and another can of Pepsi? Oh please.
Pepsi?
Yes, I got Pepsi. Yeah, anyway, there's the junction for the Conwy line, so we'll do that another time. My boys, me duckies.
So wait, I take it on that route they actually have the narrow gauge route, or part of it?
At the bottom, yeah.
Yeah.
They have basically like the, you know, indication of it.
Yeah, I'm about to say not the whole route.
Yeah, just a little bit to show off.
Oh, that's nice.
Well, it's just, again, that's an add-on that you have to get from backdatetrainsim.com.
Yeah.
So, right, so Crane, as my what do you call it, co-pilot, whatever you want to call you, co-driver, your first, what, well, in In aviation, you've got a pilot and a first officer, so you're technically my first officer. Anthony's the second officer.
We're the police.
Oh my god, yes, that's true. No, you're the second man, Anthony's the third wheel.
What?
What? Anthony's the third wheel in this one, isn't he? Because he jumped on the train third. So, and he's also quiet, as usual. Which kind of is not a requisite. I suppose he's going deaf from listening. Anthony might be the one who's hanging out of that front coach. That's why he's so quiet, because he's gone deaf. Because he's like this. And then we're in the cab like, oh, it's lovely in here, isn't it?
It's a lovely day in the countryside.
It's a lovely day to drive down the track, and if we ever stop singing, I will turn. I'm not going to say that. Right, are we 420 blazing it anyway? Oh my god, they're cold on my neck. Thank you, love. Oh! Thank you. Yay! I've got alcohol and pop. I didn't even have to move. Oh, Trey, come back. I just thought of something I could pay you with. Would you like some foamies?
What, sorry?
Roundtree random foamies. They're like strawberry and cream flavoured. They're lovely.
Oh, right, okay. Look at all these people driving.
And they could be getting the train.
Exactly.
Trains go chuff. Except this one.
Instead it goes...
Vroom.
Yeah. It goes vroom, vroom. Yeah, because I don't think a lot of rail tools come this sort of route, do they?
Oh, there's a pacer. Not a pacer,
a pacer?
Oh no, pacers and sprinters get confused me sometimes.
They're like birds of a feather. Or a feather of birds, I don't know. Hello, station.
Hello, station, he said. What are you doing here?
Goodbye, station.
Oh my god, we're speeding, guys. What do we do?
Speed up.
Okay.
James is wrong. You don't slow down.
What are we doing? Speeding up or slowing down?
Speeding. No, James is insisting we slow down, and then someone's saying we speed up. Okay, another person saying we speed up.
I am so conflicted.
Suddenly a police officer has to pull the dog on the side.
I don't think it will, though.
Yeah. Like, stop, pull over. Where exactly do I pull over?
Gotta love that sound, don't it? Now the question is, can we get this high-speed train up to 125 miles an hour without crashing?
On
I wonder.
This route?
Yeah.
Oh god.
Let's find out.
Well, considering, what was it, how long is your train?
Seven
like
coaches.
Carriages?
Seven carriages plus two power cars.
Okay.
I think.
As long as you don't hit a very tight curve, I think you'd be fine. Oh, okay, you're already doing 100, so...
110 now.
Tornado in Arriva livery.
No.
God forbid. This is why we have to have Tornado in Great Western livery. It's just required.
I'd like to see it in the new Great Western Railway livery, actually, with the metal GWR on the side.
Oh, that's...
I'd
love to see a king in that sort of livery. Mm. Like Clun Castle. Clun Castle? Clun Castle, there we go. King
actually,
Edward.
To be fair, Clun Castle would look pretty tidy in that livery. Change my mind, people.
So suddenly your mind was swapped over.
Oh, there's a place called Abigail coming up.
Modern Great Western colours.
Yeah, with the modern Great Western colours.
The only one I can remember is that Panier tank, wasn't it?
Yeah,
I was going
to say.
Oh, yeah. 1369?
Yeah. I think they spray painted it into it just for its last day in traffic.
And then they have to get permission from Great Western Railway to do that.
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's a trademarked brand.
Yeah. And a livery.
Oh.
Hello, caravans. Or chalets, whatever the fuck they are.
Swearing.
Really? Saying check your DMs.
I'm checking anyone's DMs.
You're saying what now?
Oh, it's branding patches that Riley's just sent me for the HSTs.
Oh, was this, why is there a semaphore signal there?
Part of the route is still semaphored. Right, we're going to hit 125 for a minute, I think.
Yeah. If you hit 126, I think you'll be fine, but I wouldn't stay there for too long.
I think a lot of, like, lines in Wales still use, like, semaphore signal, don't they?
I think so.
Wales is stuck in the past because, your British Rail or Network Rail didn't think they should be modernised.
Hang on, when you shut up, Anthony, what about the Cambrian line though? Wasn't that modern signals now?
I don't make the rules.
There you go, 126. You are now overtaking Mallard.
I'm going to slow it down and go back to the speed limit in a minute.
Yeah.
3 miles from Summit, she reached 126.
Wait, was it 126 or 128?
128 now.
Wait, are you talking about Mallard?
Yeah.
126.
Yeah.
It's a new world record, even though you're not driving a steam engine.
I thought we'd already agreed that Smokey Joe was beating that record.
Well, yeah.
You know what? I think if Chris ever just for shits and giggles did like Holden 101
language.
That.
Oh yeah, I do like the Holden 101, even though it's a little experimental design that only lasted 10 years.
Yeah, but that one's so famous as being one of those ones from the Hornby train sets, isn't it?
Yeah, but the only thing is they couldn't do the valve gear because it's Joy valve gear, or something like that.
It didn't look that
but it
complicated.
Causes no one joy.
Here we are at. How do you pronounce this one? Vile? Or rail?
Vile?
To be fair, it's like Smokey Joe though, isn't it? The main reason like that engine and by extension I think like those little Cali pugs are so well known is because of the Hornby model.
Well, I was reading about it. The Hornby model was supposed to be like a character model. Like that's how what it was intended to be when it was first done. As in like they intended for Smokey expected Smokey Joe to be like a a character locomotive.
Yeah.
Which means I might get away with putting the Smokey Joe in the DR Museum. On loan from Hornby Railway Company.
For the Hornby Railway Museum.
Just basically, what happened?
Though, is it?
What if Fu and Otto just used their tail cannon, though?
Has anyone tried?
Sorry.
Go on, Anthony.
Has anyone tried? Because I know Chris obviously couldn't do it, like, as it actually is the model when he released it because copyright. But has anyone actually tried reskinning the Super Pug to have like the lining on the bunker and cab the way the Smokey Joe model does?
I mean, I haven't because I'm lazy.
Well, we know that, but
I can't recall anyone doing that.
Neither can I.
God, how many campsites are in Wales? I've seen tons of holiday caravans now.
Well, you do realise that Wales is like a, a place where you go on holiday, right?
No, I wouldn't want to visit Wales.
Well, to be fair, I think me and Trace are planning on going to Wales when we get some money together.
Okay. Anywhere specific or just Wales in general?
I'm kind of thinking I want to go towards North Wales, because one, we've got all the big towns up here like like the one we're driving along on this route.
Yeah.
But, we're for Staten. Also, it's near to the railway. For me, like, you've got Festiniog Railway.
Hmm.
You've also got the Vale of Rydal.
Yeah.
So.
Well, you want to maybe want to go to those sort of railways for to see the Garrison one, the big chonkers.
Well, actually, really, there's only one engine I want to go and see, and you guys are going to probably be surprised by this. Narrow gauge wise, anywhere. Anyway. Okay. Russell.
Oh, you mean the little prairie tanky thing?
Little? It's not exactly little, is it?
Well, I've never been to these railways. I don't know how big or small they are.
Russell's the ex-Welsh Welsh Highland North Wales Narrow Gauge Railway loco.
Oh, yeah, there was that soul slippy thingy on him, wasn't there?
I think so, yeah. I just think that thing's awesome. Also, it would have been cool if we had a replica of Gary being built as well, but I digress. If I'm going to look at any operational one, though, it would probably have to be Taliesin.
Did you know that there is a replica of Gary B?
Is there?
What?
Yeah.
Is there? I must have missed this, or I must have forgotten about it early, so... Interesting, okay. Who's building it, then?
Some, like, independent group. It's not really any fixed railway, or...
The only railway it'd really be good for is the Welsh Highland Railway, though. Or the Welsh Highland Heritage, but no one ever talks about the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway.
No, that's where Russell lives.
Exactly. And I'm out of foamy, he's very upset.
Oh, it is nice, though, that they were able to get Russell back onto the full, like, big Welsh Highland route, though.
Yeah.
Not very often, though, is it?
The custard one has arrived.
Oh, no!
How are you people getting in my cab?
He's broken in.
There's not even a way to get from the bloody loco to the cab, is there?
There should be, I think. There's a door there.
Get into the engine room.
Well, maybe you can just, I don't know, get...
Oh, I think there is a way you can walk through there. Anyway, hello, Gwion.
Hello.
Good, I've got somebody who can pronounce my Welsh name for me.
By the way, has...
Be very careful what you say.
Graphic I've made.
No.
Sorry?
So, has anyone seen the graphic I've made in Model Railways?
No.
No. For Miniature Wonderland.
Gwion, can I just mention... Oh, right. I'm going to say, for one thing, we're actually driving somewhere you might like.
North Wales.
We were driving for nearly an hour.
And now there's a mayonnaise with us.
I actually haven't been anywhere along that area.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, Tom, just because I'm Welsh doesn't mean I've been all the way there. No.
I thought the Wales was like so small you could literally just step out your door. Anyway, Gwen, you've got a really big head, so you can float up here.
No, my head is not full of hot air.
Anyway, I just want to point out to everyone, language, keep it civil, please, because this is a proper video that I want to keep up on my channel for a change.
Keep it civil.
What's the video, is it?
Yes, it's a live stream slash video. But I'm trying to keep it sort of not... I'm not trying to be PC, but I'm very mindful of this whole thing with YouTube possibly being... cater more for children now. Even though I think it's BS, really. Because at the end of the day, I'm a bit worried about my channel. I don't really want anything to happen to it, you know, so...
I wouldn't do it too much, but I can understand why you wanted precautions.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, they're not big precautions. I mean, like, I'm still happy for swearing in TDRS to an extent, but maybe we need to cut down on the big words, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Like chungus.
Mm-hmm.
Complicated.
And custard.
Yeah, no, chungus off. That's a bad one, isn't it?
Also, how are we fitting five people into a cab at the moment?
I'm not quite sure. What the hell are you lot doing in my cab? Get out.
Especially since we've got a big giant dragon right there.
No, James is right. He's flying alongside.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Wait.
I'm flying in the air.
No, you're not snowman, no.
The closest I've been up there is Carnarvon.
Yeah, which isn't on the route.
Wherever that's supposed to be.
Carnarvon is at the other end of the Welsh Highland Railway.
Oh. You've got me. The only place I've been in Wales is Cardiff, and that's it.
I've never been there.
That's South Wales.
David Tennant.
That's South Wales. This is North Wales.
Yeah.
So, what's the difference between North and South Wales then, Gwilym? Apart from it being North and South? Is there a regional dialect difference?
There is.
Oh. Okay, go on, explain it.
We have what's called North Walian.
Right.
The only two I can think of off the top of my head is instead of saying for grandmother and grandfather, in the south we say Mamgia Dadki.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute actually.
And then in the north it's Naina Tide.
A what now?
Naina Tide.
Night or tide?
Nine.
Nine.
Like number nine.
Yeah.
Okay.
And tide, like the thing that goes up and down in the sea.
Right. Okay, so North Walian is weird.
The other thing is North Wales is way... Well, North West Wales...
The North Western Wales way.
Super Welsh.
Super Welsh, okay.
Well, I mean, the Welsh language is extremely prominent over there.
Rather than South Wales, which is that you lot happen to speak English.
Well, southeast of Wales,
mm-hmm.
Welsh barely exists. Southwest Wales, I mean the whole of the west coast of Wales, you start getting into much stronger Welsh territory.
But regarding.
But in North Wales, it's like almost everywhere you go in Northwest Wales, they're gonna be talking Welsh.
Well, it's Wales, so yeah. If I saw an American there, I'd be like, okay, you're far afield.
Kind of reminds me of a post on Facebook about some people on a bus somewhere, like in Cardiff or wherever.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah, and like some person has a go at someone for not speaking English in England, and they turn around and say, well, she's speaking Welsh and she's in Wales.
Yeah, it was basically some sort of like racist comment because he thought that she was speaking like
a foreign language.
Foreign language.
Yeah.
It's like, no, she's speaking the native language.
Yeah.
Welsh.
Wales. Have you seen what I'm actually driving, Gwilym? As in, like, what livery?
I haven't actually looked at you.
I hate
for
you
some
so
reason,
much.
I would like, oh, Tom is streaming, but he's not streaming. Because I expected you'd be streaming on here, but I forgot you actually stream on YouTube.
I am streaming on YouTube. No, I'm in a Virgin Trains Virgin Trains HFT set.
Yeah.
So I feel like I'm driving a Hornby train set again.
Yeah.
Like Trent keeps saying.
All I can think it is as a it's the only thing I've seen before in like 00 gauge as a HST. Train was not going mad at all.
Gwion.
Mm-hmm.
You know on this Wunderla and thing, those like pictures at the top, are those things you've actually made yourself or are they stock?
They are clip art. Why is that?
Okay.
No, I was super lazy and I just ripped off a bunch of clip art.
Okay. And I take it, by the way, that 5230, is that your model?
That.
Hang on, I better go back to the cab for this because we're going to explain this yet again to everybody on YouTube. This might be a way of getting some people to actually enter in competition, actually.
Tiny shameless plug.
Shameless plug time, everyone! Shameless plug time!
Don't plug into the tray, you might lose power.
We as in myself, my YouTube channel, we on Reese Davis. Not SimNation, different channel.
Yeah, because SimNation died like 12 years ago.
No, SimNation is still a thing.
Which reminds me, you guys need to buy a 7 Black Wagon when it comes out, because I helped make it.
Anyway, back
to Gwion.
So, as of recent, because of the Great Model Railway Challenge and all that malarkey, I've kind of kickstarted my YouTube channel back up, and I'm doing a lot of model railway stuff. And I'm soon going to be posting details on a giveaway, and it is a pretty damn big giveaway, all things considered, because most of the time when you see these giveaways, it's for some stupid wagon or something, and it's just a ready-to-run model. This time, in this case, it's not. We're going to be giving away a Great Western 5205.
Thank you for getting the classification correct.
I had a kitchen. Giving out a 5205 model?
Yeah, giving out that 5205 that's in Model Railway Chat.
That's on the DGJP Discord server in Model Railways. There's a weathered one. It's been done by TRS Trains. Kyle there, he's in collaboration on this giveaway. So basically, I provided the logo, he's provided the weathering, and we'll be putting up that giveaway soon on the channel. The details will all be there, and it basically, you enter by doing various things, subscribing, following people on whatever, social media, etc. The more you do, the more entries you get, effectively. It's one of those kind of Gleam-style giveaways, so...
So guess who? Guess which member here isn't going to be doing any of that?
I don't have social media, so I won't anyway.
So Crane's out, anyway.
If someone would like to send me that model, I'd be very grateful.
Yeah, DDJP would also appreciate a model of a 5205 for his...
I mean, I've already got a 72, but I still...
I need to get a 72, Crane. I need to get a 72.
This particular model as well has been renumbered. It's got etch plates on it.
Nice.
Renumbered 5230. And that's of local area to me. So it started its life off in Llechi, which is a stone's throw from Swansea, and later in its life it went to the other side of Swansea, to Aberdare. It's definitely run through my parts a lot.
Oh.
And you know, these locos were known for basically short hauls of coal from the mines to the ports in South Wales. So it's a really cool little bit of kit. You can run long coal trains with private owner wagons or whatever you want to put behind it. And yeah, it's gonna be something pretty cool. So
can I ask also,
people make sure
the front
you
end, by the way,
what's
on,
that?
On the model.
Sorry?
Can I ask what happened to the buffer beam and the front pony truck on the model?
Oh, I'm not 100% sure. I'm gonna be asking him when he brings it over tomorrow.
Because it's missing its coupling hook. It's got a new vac pipe, and it's got something in where the NEM pocket would be.
I would just like to point out,
the photos aren't of the finished product.
I would also like to point out that it's actually kind of nice that we've got something that's sort of related, kind of, to what we're doing on the stream, seeing as it's about Wales and it's a Welsh loco, isn't it? And one of my best mates, Gwion, is Welsh.
Yes, with a Welsh name called Gwion.
Yeah. Which, to be fair, I'm starting to, like, you know, over the... How many years have I known Miguel? Like, 4 years? 5 years? Whatever it is now?
Let's see... 2015.
Yeah, so it's 4 years now. Gwion has now become such a boring name, because it's... As in, what I mean by that is because, obviously, I'm so used to you, Gwion, if someone says the word Gwion, ever...
It won't
like,
faze
it doesn't,
you at
it
all.
Doesn't faze me at all. Because I just know it's like, oh, yeah, Gwion's my mate. And then they're like, no, Gwion's a Welsh name. Yeah, he's my mate.
He's that boy.
But it's funny because I was on the phone today to a third-party company at work, and they asked my name, and I'm like, right, my name's Gwion Rhys Davis. And at the end of the call, thank you, Graham. I'm sorry, what?
they think your name was Graham.
That's not the only time this happened. I made a phone call to Backman about stuff regarding Wally and stuff, and I called their reception desk. And then they patched me through to them, and they told them that it was Gareth Rhys Davis calling.
Oh my god!
Wow. So when he picked up, he's like, he had no idea who I was until I was like, oh wait, hang on, oh it's Gwion. Hello Gwion.
Hello Gwion. Nice day for hijacking.
And he was just like, oh, you see, I was told it was Graham Davis. I'm like, I think I know one. He's like, do I know him? And the woman on the phones, the reception, transferring the call was like,
yeah.
He sounds like he knows you.
I hope this is entertaining my viewers tonight, because I was intending on doing this all on my own. I'm actually kind of glad I do get people in the call.
I found myself on board, and then things.
And then everyone started coming in because you did, Crane. So thank you for coming in to the train.
Long story short, don't let your parents give you a weird Welsh name. Although, I'm sure it's way better than my brother. Of which I still can't pronounce his name properly.
Uh-oh.
It's... And I will... I have to put a lot of effort into pronouncing this. Hlir.
It looks like... I've seen his name on Facebook, because I've actually friended him, Gwion, but I've seen his name... come up as a friend suggestion. It looks like liar.
It's LLY. The Y has a little roof over it.
It's a shed.
Upwards pointing chevron.
It's got a shed on it.
and then R.
Yeah.
It's quite funny.
It's almost like it's like Lear, isn't it? Basically.
It's Lear. And I spent many years trying to pronounce that, and my parents, my brother, constantly having a go at me about not being able to pronounce it and saying I'm lazy because I can't shape the shape my tongue has to make that sound.
Anyway, I just wanted to point out to the ladies and gentlemen now, we're about to come through, where are we? Yeah, this is Shotton low level. Now, it's kind of nice, actually, because they've also modelled Shotton high level.
The high ground, the low ground.
Yeah, so you got, I have the high ground, mannequin.
I have the high ground, virgin. What?
Kind of nice that you got like the railway going over a railway, though. That'd be nice in the scenario. Yeah. And it's single track, though. Wait, is it single track? Oh no, it's not a double track.
No, it's double track.
Okay.
Actually, I'm just gonna shameless plug a little bit more.
Oh my god. Okay, back to the cab I go then.
Again, you're going to drain the HSD power if you keep plugging.
Yeah, but Jesus.
If anyone
Jesus.
Wants to check out the loco before the giveaway is over, it will be...
On your channel. On
presentation. No.
Oh, hang on. I've got to pause.
Oh, okay.
Because I need to ask people a question. Because this bit here looks like it used to be an island platform of some sort. Now, I need...
Possibly, yes.
I'm going to say what I'd like. If anybody who lives up in Wales or wherever, whoever happens across this video, there's certain sections on the North Wales coastal where that happens. Did these used to be island platforms? Because I really like the idea of there being old island platforms. Because it reminds me a little bit of... the saddest thing in preservation for me, which is Belgrave and Birstall Station. Which is now left to north on the Great Central. And literally the only reason is they moved it like up.
Like, what station did you go through, Tom?
I literally just went through Shotton.
Shotton.
Yeah, so it's between, literally the first station east of Shotton.
Okay. Have a look at old Ordnance Survey.
Yeah, maps. Or you could just look on, normally it says on North Wales, like, you know, whatever. It'd say on the wiki anyway. But, going back to Belgrave and Birstall, I don't know why it upsets me so much. I think it's because the station itself was still there up until like 1980, 1990, or whenever it was. And they literally just took the platform away, built left and north, like 100, not even 100 yards south of the old station. And they left the bridge in place. But it would have been better if it had gone to Belgrave and Birstall, but apparently it was due to vandalism that it was taken away. Which is a real shame, because it's sort of like, it's almost the same as me, let's say, for example, let me think of a station on the DR. It's like me basically taking away Manston 4, and then making a new station in the cutting a little bit further down, which would be Mearcombe Moor, you know?
Yeah.
So it's almost like me doing that, and it would sadden people who watch the series, for example. Who, I mean, I don't even know whether there's any fans of Manston 4 Station out there. I keep intending to have it burned down in a cataclysmic fire, but I keep forgetting to do it.
You keep forgetting to burn it down.
I keep forgetting to burn it down because I can't even know whether people like Manston 4. Because I've never actually asked, I don't ever ask people what their favourite stations on the DR actually are. I mean, mine is probably going to be... I think my favourite station is probably Gannon Junction. Anyone would like to weigh in on this conversation?
Well, I would say mine's Axley, but yeah.
Ew.
I like Axley. Fill off.
Okay, fine. Bye.
It's got Axe in its name. It's pretty cutting edge.
It's Axley.
No, that's the stage. Well, that's where Chairman like tried to adopt the Soma branch because he had Axley. He was like, oh yeah, cutting edge. We're going to put all the technologies in this station. We're going to have self-service ticket machines. We're going to have self-service trains, self-service coffee machines. You're going to be lifted onto your train via a little spring underneath the track. All this jazz. Anyone else
they
got
even have wireless LEDs?
Well, has anybody else got a favourite station?
Well, people are saying it in the comments.
Oh.
Well,
I'll have a look at that in a minute.
There's also Farquhar. It's like that's Sodor.
That's Sodor, for Christ's sake.
And that's,
I mean,
Riley who said that.
Right. Okay. Well, Riley's gonna get killed, so he doesn't count.
That's funny.
But anyway, I tell you what. I actually, as much as like, I know Gwyn, you complained about South Wales Coastal. But I'm kind of glad I got North Wales Coastal at its 70% discount. Because it's for under a tenner, it's not a bad route, to be honest. And it's quite long, so if I ever wanted to actually you know, run a proper scenario on here, or do what I'm doing now, which is just, you know, running the entire length and having a look around. Because, like, in general, I haven't mentioned much about the scenery, but it all seems quite tidy to me. There's a couple of custom assets I've seen here and there, so can't really complain.
Well, yeah, like the castle wall award.
Yeah, that at Conway was really nice. Was it Conway? Yeah, Conway. Or Com, whatever it was. Right, where are we now anyway? We're at Saltney Junction. And then we're coming into... Oh, I think we're nearly at Chester.
Hey, sorry, Quia. Did you say that you weathered that model yourself? Or?
No, one of his friends did.
It's weathered by TRS Trains, who does weathering as a service. And, well, not just weathering, he does modifications and everything. And even scratch builds. He does some crazy-ass good scratch builds.
Okay. Does he have a website or something? Or?
Facebook page, TRS Trains.
Okay. Bloody Facebook.
Can't catch a break.
Can't catch a Kit Kat.
I think he wants to get a website soon.
Well, that's something else I've noticed that's good about the H50T and the AP one in particular. If you want it in the cab, you actually get a little AWS thing come up in the corner when there's an AWS, so you haven't got to keep going back to the cab.
Okay.
So that's pretty handy. So we are now approaching Chester. So I'm actually going to go back in the cab for this bit because I want to see what the scenery is like around here. But what do you think of this?
Far away from crew then?
No, it's 20-ish miles away from crew. About 21 miles from crew. But, in all honesty, I'd like to ask the viewers and the guys here, because I'm actually interested, should I do more videos / streams like this, where I basically... It's kind of like cab ride videos, but I might even extend the dark drive to me driving other, like, different locos that are already available in-game, like, for example, whatever, like, you know, showcasing both routes and locos, just for a bit of fun, really.
Yeah,
like the shorter, like the longer routes like this, do them as live streams, and then the shorter routes maybe do them as actual proper videos or something. What do you guys think?
So basically, like I'll say sort of like what we did with South Devon, but then South Devon was a bit of a
That was a bit of a cock storm, whatever. So yeah.
Yeah.
But what do you think, Anthony?
Well, I think Anthony's well sleepy at the moment.
Oh.
He's alive.
Oh,
is he
alive?
Oh no,
I was asking your opinion, seeing as I keep telling you that I value your opinion quite highly. What you think of me doing more videos like this under the Dark Drives banner? Because Dark Drives is like like fresh stuff, and this would be me going on either older routes or routes I don't drive very often, and just like, you know, because this is like I don't know. I'm kind of finding it quite, you know, relaxing, not having to pressurize myself on anything. So. Especially because, as I mentioned earlier on in the stream, I have sent a script out to people to do for the next episode. So for people who keep asking when that's going to be, well, as Tracy said, bloody wait.
Cool your tits.
Because even she said people have got to understand that I have got life outside of doing this lot, you know, which is perfectly true. And also, like, you know, I've got work. It's nearly Christmas, so I've got to do my overtime at work. I'm trying to stay out of hospital this year, guys. Remember, last 2 years I've been in hospital around this time of year, so no thank you. So anyway, here you are, Chester. I actually quite like this station, especially because it's nice
to
reach here.
I was going to go to Chester at one point. I never did.
It's quite Chester.
What, Guillaume?
Nothing.
Did you just say it's quite chesty?
Maybe.
What, have you got... Wait, have you...
That was a horrid pun and you know it.
Have you got a chesty cough when you come in here?
I think he does.
There you go, I tried to change it so it's more appropriate. So we've become PC, by the way. Are we trying to anyway? Are we going to try and become PC?
PC Alan.
Well, pretty crap.
No, well, I was already pretty crap. What I meant was more appropriate for younger audiences, I suppose. I don't want to be like that, but I suppose, I mean, like, I can try a little bit more. Whatever,
well, unless you start doing counting, it's like, here's the number one. Then we need to probably worry. But
never
I think for what it is, for general, like, kid, well, young teens.
Well, it's not even like, well, not even for kids. Like, I'm not trying to be kid friendly. I'm just trying to sort of be like, you know, not even advertiser friendly because I don't really care
family
about.
Family friendly.
Yeah, family friendly because I'm not really advertiser friendly either because let's face it, I mean, advertisers aren't really looking to advertise on channels like mine. They want to go for Squirrel, don't they? Who I've annoyingly been watching lately. You guys know Quill, don't you?
He's
the guy who does, like, the, he does a few first looks. He's a bit like Alan Thompson Sim. Even Alan Thompson Sim as well, you know. But
Alan Thompson?
As a station, actually, Chester, I quite like. I suppose this is where, I'm assuming you'd get, like, local trains from Chester to Crewe, then. Because you've got the bay platforms here. I kind of wouldn't mind doing one of those sort of services, actually. I might even build a scenario for it.
That's the canopies in one will look a bit patchy, if I'm honest. Like, they're all
yeah, but I like them. I like that. It sort of gives it a bit more character. It's got character, though, this station. You've got to give it that. It reminds me of Bournemouth, in a way.
So my mail app has all of a sudden decided to identify me not as Gwion Rhys Davies, but as the Swansea Hackspace.
Nice. Anyway.
Okay.
Who wants to... shall we go to this view, and shall we have some thrash out of Chester, as we've got 20 miles left, 21 miles left to get to Thingy Bob. So, are we ready, boys and girls?
No.
Wait,
Alan. That's actually not a bad idea.
I need to think of a horn to do before we leave. Hang on. Can I do Don't You Think Girlfriend Was Hot Like Me? Or Don't You Wish, even? No, I need to be high tone.
Don't you wish your babies would you were hot like my what?
Okay. There you go. All right, let's go. Notch 5.
Yeah, I think JRS came up. Well, had to go.
Crane, you're ruining the Clag Sharp.
Meanwhile,
at the back.
I've been watching that new trailer, you know, the one that shows off the new design?
The Sonic.
Oh, the Sonic trailer, yeah. It looks better, definitely.
Yeah. What a transformation. What's interesting about that trailer? It feels like it's completely different.
Yeah.
Because you have this first book, which was very
vague.
Well, alien. And it was very serious and it was very kind of acid. It felt very different. This one feels very more kind of childish, fun.
It's more geared towards babbies. Geared towards the younger audience.
More family friendly.
Yeah. Because the first trailer, sort of, to me, was it didn't really have much depth to it.
Depth.
I said.
Oh.
But the new one looks more. I tell you what, though, right? I do like, as much as I don't like the fact that there literally is zero integrity with Warner Brothers for what they've done. Is it Warner Brothers who are doing it?
Paramount.
Sorry, I don't know why I thought Warner Brothers. I must be watching too much Jim Sterling. Anyway. But yeah, there's no integrity, because if they would actually, if they were actually, as Jim has said, because I'm watching a video this morning, if they had any sort of, you know, an artistic bone in their body, they'd have kept their original guns and kept the original design. But I have to be the one to say, I actually really, really like the new design. It looks so much better.
Yeah, it's more appealing to me. Yeah,
that's the thing. Because if you watch like if you go in the cinema and watch something like Sonic, you want the character to look at least
somewhat like
the character. And the original design, it didn't really look that much like Sonic. It looked just hideous.
More like some alien rather than with a little bit of.
It looked like somebody wearing a cosplay costume.
Yeah.
Yes. I see that. It's
more like Sonic.
It's so funny.
We're gonna 420 blaze it to Crewe, by the way.
Okay. What, in 20 miles?
We're just gonna notch 5 for 20 miles. Why not?
Okay. Suddenly the clutch went.
I wouldn't be surprised if they've actually changed the script, not just the character.
You mean to change the tone? I think they've changed the tone of the film, haven't they?
Yeah.
It feels so different that I can't look at it and go, this is the same film anymore. I actually think it's entirely different.
Well, yeah. I noticed, in a lot of the scenes where you can tell that were there in the original trailer, and they've obviously now had the new design put in, they look like they've been reshot, like the actual scene.
Yeah.
Like the scene in the garage, for example, where you meet, like, the guy comes across Sonic. Like, the actual shot...
The composition of the shots are different.
I
so they
really
have probably been reshot.
For them to reshoot, though, and really expensive.
Yeah, but then again, if they want to do right by... Because remember, Sega are probably looking at this and going, you know, don't cock this up, don't cock this up, sort of thing.
Don't ruin our brand.
So they're probably going to
inject... It's not like Sega cocked up 20 years ago.
Oh yeah, but we don't care about that. It's not. Then again, it's not like we had Super Mario that one time, Super Mario Brothers. Do you remember that?
Gosh.
Anyone remember Super Mario Bros? Eh?
I kind of enjoy that. It's silly.
Yeah, I was going to say, the thing with Super Mario Bros was it's so bad that it was good.
It's so bad that it was good. Yeah, it's gone so bad, it's come full circle.
It literally did. It literally was so panned by, you know, it's also, you've got to remember, it was one of the first ever films that were based upon a video game. So you've got to give
it some slack. Ironically, the first one apparently was another Mario film.
Was it?
I ended up seeing this a couple of years ago. Apparently, like, the first film to be released based on a video game was actually, like, an animated Japanese film based on Mario.
Okay.
I think I've heard of that one before, yeah.
It was only released in Japan, though, so it wasn't...
Okay. It wasn't to the Western audiences, yeah.
And the only reason I know that is because there was this other review channel that I watched who actually decided to cover it. It was basically... he did it as of a tribute to Juwario, because it was just after he'd committed suicide.
What is
but
it?
Then,
wait, who was that? Was that the guy creating Mario?
No, Juwario. He was a Channel Awesome contributor who left to sign about a year later. He took his own life.
Oh.
But then, a bit of an awkward story. That review's actually now been pulled down because of what was found out about Juwario when the whole Channel Awesome controversy blew up.
Can we not bring into this video, seeing as it's not supposed to be that? This video is supposed to be us driving on the...
Alright, fine, I'll tell you later.
Talk to us later about it. You've put
me off my depression stuff. More fun stuff.
More fun stuff, like, you know, hanging out and listening to a HFT go...
That's boring.
It's not boring. This is the sort of thing people like me enjoy, and certain people enjoy watching.
And certain people do the thing.
You're just listening lazily to the left.
To the right. Make a U-turn.
To the right. Far right.
Take the third exit. You will reach your final destination.
But yeah, I'd rather not talk about people committing suicides or controversies on this sort of video. Just FYI.
Anyway. Take a U-turn when possible.
Yeah, let's literally take a U-turn right now and talk about something fun.
How about you put the brakes on right now, because I think there's a speed limit coming up.
Oh, crumbs, so there is. Anyway, let's slow down. Actually, no, do you know what? No. I said I'm gonna blaze it all the way to through, so we are.
You have reached your final destination.
So, as we're now at the last 10 miles of the route anyway, I think I should give my... closing thoughts overall. Actually, I am going to slow down a little bit. I don't want to crash.
Yeah, not when you've got...
Not when I've gotten this far.
So far.
I don't think I'll crash here,
so
but...
Is that a speed camera?
I don't know, but there is no platform here. That's cool.
He's just sitting on his own. She's like, hello. Hello, semi-full signal. Semi-circle signal. There you go, back up to speed.
What'd you do, Will?
I whacked my arm.
Oh no.
But yeah, overall, I mean, I would recommend getting this route, even though I got it for like 70%. If you like nice long drives like this, like, and as you've seen, we've been able to keep a consistent high speed throughout this. We've not had any sort of, you know, hairy moment where we've had a derailment or whatever.
Well, you say that.
Well, you know what I mean. Like, there hasn't been any really sharp corners or anything, so I think it would be a good route to do a race on at some point. Because I think it's long enough and it's got enough
well,
going
it's
100
on. Miles, so...
Yeah, so definitely
a 100-mile race. Who can last the longest?
Well, it's not just that. This would be good to do a steam special on or something. Because again, it's mainly double track mainline. There's only one section of single track over that one really nice bridge towards Holyhead. So I decided to steer the conversation away from what we're talking about, but as we're nearing the end of this run and the end of this particular part, this particular stream, I just wanted to say, like, as much as we like to criticise route building and whatnot, from what I can see from this route, I mean, yeah, some of the scenery here is a little bit, you know, cut and paste, but overall, I must admit, like, even the line side foliage and stuff, as much as, like, people like Train Sim World, I still think that TS, like, normal TS is the way to go if DTG continue improving their engine rather than bolting shit onto it that we don't need. Pardon my language. But we don't need, like, loads of stuff being put on this. Like, for example, I mean, what use is... Hang on, is it that? Or was it that? Hang on. Yeah, the filters I've got here. Like, you know, what does that achieve for me, really?
Nothing.
Like, nothing, virtually. Because I can do any... If I need to edit any of that stuff in TDRS or whatever, I can do it in my video editor.
I think it's more meant for people like with screenshots who don't want to do like.
Yeah, but even then, it's just.
It's not something for people just, who want to edit. I think it's for people who just want to watch it and play it as if they're watching it.
Yeah, but even then, like, my argument there, I suppose, is that. Like, DTG
I think they just
are
did
adding.
It because they could.
Well, it's not that. It's not, I think they put it in there, Gwion, because they were trying to get people to use that rather than, like, Railworks Enhancers and whatnot.
Yeah.
But, back to my actual point, which is that they technically bolted that lot on. To this build of the game, which is TS 2020. My issue with that is it's, especially with 64-bit as well, it seems to be making the game more and more unstable, I've noticed recently. And what worries me, if they keep doing that...
isn't because of that, though.
Well, it seems to be for many different issues, doesn't it? Because a lot of people have different issues with different things.
Lots of little nitty-gritty changes here and there, and it's causing big problems elsewhere.
Well, I mean, like, I've had the issue with trying to stream to Discord and edit, when I edit a scenario a certain amount of times, it crashes.
Yeah,
it basically claims it runs out of memory. I think what's happening is it's loading up memory, but then it's not dumping it afterwards, like, after you edit something.
I don't even think that is, because I look at my memory usage, I record it, and it doesn't show any spikes or anything. It's pretty fucking dumb. I think that there's, basically, I think there's an exception error going on, and... Train Sim's default response to that is memory out of memory error. And I think it's just dovetail being lazy.
Because some people say they get a vertex buffer error, which is the same thing as a memory out of memory error. Because I got one where it said it divided by zero. I was like, what?
What?
Yeah.
So basically,
I actually saved a screenshot of that where basically the game failed to load because it divided by zero. It's like, and that's the dumbest thing a computer can do. It's like, you know what happens when you divide by zero? Nothing, because you can't divide anything by zero. You can't divide it between nothing.
No. Something does happen when you divide by zero. Do you not remember?
The universe.
Oh, yes, I never remember where he's going with this.
Wait, hang on.
And Tom, don't use your power until you leave the.
I can't remember where that comes from.
Tom, listen. And the pyramid and the island explode.
If you want a mathematical explanation of why you can't divide by zero, it's basically because
we don't need one. I'm just making a comment.
It literally is going to be like a 2 second.
Okay, go on then, because we're nearing the end of the stream. And I need to say my final words on this. So go on.
Here, I'll time you,
Gwion.
As you shut up. As your denominator approaches zero, your result approaches infinite. Is basically how it works. You can't divide by zero because that's infinite.
Okay.
you can feel the interest in the room, can't you? But anyway, the whole point is that the game itself is a bit iffy, but I still would choose this over TS World. I think a lot of people would. Because there's a lot more, not just functionality, I'd say, but there's a lot more variety in TS, and there's a lot more editability, there's a lot more play value, whereas TF World isn't. But going back to my point about the route before we finish, is that I noticed when I was driving Great Western Express, it looks very pretty and all that, but it doesn't have the sort of, how can I explain it? Because obviously you can see the assets have been recycled. It doesn't have the pizzazz or the sort of... the charm or unique feel that this game does. Like, I know that sounds a bit weird and different, but overall, I would say, me personally, I mean, the fact that I actually only bought this yesterday, and yet I still fancy driving on it again today, says something about a route, I think. And considering this is the first of what I'm planning on a new series of, like, in-between videos while I'm working on TDRS and stuff, I think that, you know, this sort of route is a good one to start on, because it's a nice long route. It hasn't given me much in the way of trouble on the way down, because, you know, usually I get trouble with my route, but, you know, I haven't had any trouble. There's only been a little bit of stuttering from time to time, as Crane can attest to.
Yeah.
And I think, I mean, like, now I've just had one, but I am coming into crew, which I'm going to, before I stop at the station, I want to show you guys that we've got the, you've got the thingy bob there, the prototype, what do you call it, APTE, sat in a siding up Crew Heritage, which is quite a nice little Easter egg to show off at the end of the route, at the end of the run.
Spoilers!
But, I mean, I don't expect everybody to agree with me, because, like, obviously I know that modern isn't everyone's taste on this channel. I know a lot of people just prefer, like, Steam Era. Or me, who just more or less exclusively normally just drives on the DR because it's all I'm comfortable with. I'm going to just get in the cab for this section, I think. Oh, no, I'm not going to stay where I am. No, I'm not going to get in the cab. Oh, no, I'm going to get in the cab. But overall, I would say if you're interested in high-speed runs or whatnot, I'd go for this route, personally, especially if it's on sale. It's a decent little route, and I think this is one of the ones where RSC have probably tried their best, rather than, well, I say RSC, you know, DTG, rather than, you know, what usually happens, which is that they sort of make a half-assed effort. I think they made a good effort on this one, which, by the way, this is Crew Heritage here, and look, APTE, is it APTE?
The preserved ATP,
one?
ATP, I think.
ATP. Yeah, this is a production one. ATP.
That's just not a bad model.
Well, no, of course it's not. It's based on the original model, I think. The one that's in TS, the one I've got.
I still like that this was basically the teaser before the actual working model dropped.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, we've now arrived at our final lead destination, which is Crewe. So I would mainly like to thank Crane, actually, of all people, because he came into the call and gave me the company all the way down here, so thank Crane. And to everyone else who turned up as well, cheers guys for accompanying me on this journey. Sorry if it seemed a bit like I'm being a bit, you know, PC or whatever, but I kind of just had this whole thing with YouTube on my mind today. But anyway, I'm going to end it there because we've made it to Crewe.
Did you actually fit the whole train in the platform, by the way?
No.
Oh.
But anyway, that is the end of this because it's going to throw me out in a second, so let's just go back to this. So thank you everyone for watching, and we will see you next time. I hope you enjoyed the video.